Hello viewers, welcome to another video. In this video, we will going to learn how to use multimeter. So let's find out what is multimeter. A multimeter is a device which is used to measure voltage, resistance and current. So there are two types of multimeter, analog and digital. This one is the analog multimeter in which we have a needle and a scale on which this needle moves and may show the measured value. The one on my right is the digital multimeter, which has an LCD and it shows the measured value in alphanumeric or digits on the LCD. So there are two versions of digital multimeter. The first one is the switched one, which is a manual multimeter, and we have to select manually between the ranges of different function. For example, the voltage ranges between 200 millivolts to 1000 volts, so we need to select the proper voltage range before measurement. In auto range multimeter, there is no range, we only have to select the function and it will automatically detect and measure the value. In multimeter, we have red and black leads. The red lead is connected to the voltage, resistance or ampere port of the multimeter and is considered to be the positive terminal. Similarly, the black lead is connected to the common port of the multimeter and is considered to be the negative terminal. The probe is the insulation which is used to handle the tip on the tested connection, and tips are the conductor which is connected at the end of the probe and it provides a connection point to be measured. So what is display and dial? The green line shows the digital display and it is basically an alphanumeric LCD on which a measured value is shown. The white line shows the meter dial. It is used to change the range of the function. The panel indicator shows the range of any function. And the blue line shows the probe connection for red and black leads. These are the common digital multimeter symbols. I will just read out few of these symbols. This one is for AC voltage. This symbol is for DC voltage. This is for hertz and it is a unit of frequency. This symbol is for audible continuity. You can hear the sound whenever you measure the continuity between these two points. So let's see how we measure the voltage. There are two types of voltages, AC and DC. The alternating current voltage is just like what we have in our house, that is 230 or 110 volt AC. The DC voltage is similar to what we have on the battery, which is 12 volt DC. So first, we properly select between these two voltages that which voltage we want to measure. Then turn the dial on the voltage and select the proper range. Remember to select the next higher value. Now connect the black and red leads in parallel between the two points where the measurement is required. Just like here, you can see here that the person is measuring the voltage between these two terminals and the meter is showing 230 volt AC. Similarly, in DC voltage, always try to connect the positive terminal with the red probe and the negative terminal with the black probe. That is how the meter will read the positive voltage. If you reverse the polarity or the terminal of the DC voltage, you can see a negative sign appear next to the measured value. You have connected probes in the reverse direction. For the resistance measurement, as we all know that resistance is the opposition to the current, and the symbol for the resistance is ohm omega. So for the resistance measurement, first we move the dial to the resistance and then we select the proper range. Or if we are not sure about the range, then we will select the maximum value. Disconnect the power source before testing. Remember that don't test the resistance in the energized circuit. And it is always a better practice to remove the component or the resistance from the entire board in order to properly measure the resistance of that component. Just like as you can see here in the picture, that we first disconnect resistance R2 and then measure the resistance. Here you can see that we select the dial on the ohm, select the proper range, and then connect both the probes across the resistance, and meter shows the value of the resistance. Now we see that what is continuity measurement. Now we see how to measure continuity. So what is continuity? The continuity is the presence of complete path for the current flow. So in order to check whether the circuit is complete or whether the circuit is closed, we use continuity test. For this, we first select the dial on the continuity. You can see the continuity is represented by this symbol. Normally this symbol is placed near the resistance, and both these functions are selectable from the same position on the dial. Then when you see this symbol appear on the LCD, it means that now multimeter is in the mode of continuity. So with the circuit de-energized and the component isolated, connect the lead across the component. So for the measurement of the continuity, you again follow the same procedure as you have followed when you are measuring the resistance. Do not check the continuity in the energized circuit. The multimeter beeps or it produces a sound if it finds a closed path. And if the circuit is open, it will remain silent and the multimeter will not beep. It means that the circuit is open. The person is checking the continuity between these two points, and you can see that the meter is producing the sound, and also the value of the resistance is zero or in the points. Now, in order to measure the current, normally in the digital multimeters, we can only measure DC current in a very small range between milliamps to 5 ampere. So for the current measurement, select the dial on the current shown by this symbol A. Disconnect the power source before testing. Place the multimeter in series with the circuit, and then reconnect the power source and energize the circuit. For example, this positive terminal is connected to a bulb, and the other terminal of the bulb is connected to the positive lead, and the negative probe of this meter is connected to the negative terminal. So in this way, by connecting these two probes in series with the load, a series current will flow and it will be measured by this meter. So this is all in this video. I hope you understand how to use a multimeter. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.